What's going on, guys? In today's video, we're going to be talking about the Suray SVT75 Pro, and these is just going to be the rapid release legs. I've recently just got this for, you know, my production here in the studio, and I upgraded from the Manfrotto. I believe this is the MVH200AH tripod. Now, I am going to be using the same head on the SVT75 because I only got the legs. I might get the head later on, but we're going to be comparing or just giving a small synopsis on why I upgraded from the MVH200AH to the Suray SVT75 Pro. Let's go ahead and talk about it. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to grab the Manfrotto tripod first. So we're going to talk about this first on the list. And I'm going to be using the table, so if my head gets cut off, that's what's going on. So this is the MVH200AH Manfrotto tripod, fluid head, of course, height adjustable, not as easily height adjustable as the SVT75, but we will get into that. But the only thing that this tripod did not necessarily help me with was the weight capacity. Now, I did just recently upgraded and got the Edelkrone Motion Bundle, and I can't even run the slider on this tripod. You have a 50 millimeter bowl, not necessarily bad, but you know, industry standard starts at 75, goes all the way up to 100. So you kind of want to kind of upgrade as the time goes by. Now, I didn't have this tripod for around 4 to 5 years, and it's going to do another 4 to 5, maybe 6 to 7 years before I need to upgrade it. So what was one of the biggest reasons why I upgraded to the SVT75 Pro? One of those biggest reasons was the 75 millimeter bowl. You're able to find 75 millimeter bowls a lot more frequently than you are the 50 millimeter bowls. The locking mechanism on the legs is kind of, it works every now and then. And it is kind of finicky, you guys will see, but I'm gonna show you guys basically how this folds down, basically how long it takes for me to get this at a height that I need for filming. So it has all these latches, and it's like a two-stage latch system. So you got one set of latches that lets your legs out this far, and then you have another set of latches which is gonna let your legs out from here on. Now, I think the SVT gets a little bit higher than the MVH200AH. Now, they both have mid-level spreaders, so that is good. But on this one, you cannot get rid of it. It is stationary. Now, you can take it off, but you're going to have tools and everything to actually do that. So this is the MVH200AH tripod. Hopefully, you guys can see it here in the frame. Now, like I said, I wanted to use the same head, so we can come from this head back to this head and be good to go. So I'm still kind of universal with all my tripods, but I did upgrade the legs and kept the same head to just get a little bit more robustness, especially when I'm holding my FS5. Let's go ahead and take the FS5 off of here, put it on the table. And like I said, it's just cumbersome. So to take this down, I would have to, of course, pull the leg spreader up and then go around and hit every latch. Now let me show you how easy the SVT is. And you know, just for a rule of thumb, they do come in bags. This is the Manfrotto bag. It's nothing wrong with it. Like I said, it's not a comparison. This is just basically summing up what I had and what I have now. So firstly, we're gonna go ahead and look at the bag. So this is the bag of the Suray. I mean, it's just a bag, you know. It's a little bit bigger, a little bit more robust. I did turn this little nameplate around because it actually shows the brand of the tripod right there. Of course, I got it right here too, but some black gaff tape will be able to take that out, so I'm not really too worried about that. And I normally, you know, very seldomly take my bags out with my tripods in them. Usually I just take the tripods if I'm going short distance. If I'm going a long distance, of course, I will pack them up. So this is the SVT75 Pro, and what makes this Pro is the mid-level spreader and also the quick release here for the 75 millimeter bowl. Now, of course, already you're probably looking at this and being like, wow, I see exactly why you might have switched over to the SVT from the Manfrotto tripod. And that was one of the biggest things, that is quick to basically go from one 75 millimeter bowl straight to another tripod, some legs. You might have another camera set up that has the bowl on it, on the bottom of the camera. Just need to set it on some legs. Here you go. So the reason I got the legs was because the tripod legs itself was $649. Now, the actual head was another $649. I didn't think I needed it because I had an MVH head here that I could use and is still Manfrotto compatible, like the one that my camera's sitting on right now. We are watching from the A7IV. This one's still compatible, this one's still compatible. So I can literally put any of my cameras on any of these tripods. Now, the legs was the biggest thing for my Edelkrone slider because they didn't necessarily go out as wide on the Manfrotto tripod, and that's because it has a leg spreader that's not removable. So let's go ahead and talk about, I guess, one of the biggest features of this tripod. I'm gonna go ahead and slide it down, and we're gonna be talking about that mechanism as well. So this is the SVT, not the MVH, the SVT 75. Now this is it's a beautiful tripod. I love this tripod. You got, you know, it's not a dual bar, it's one single bar, carbon fiber. And of course, like we talked about, these single latches at the top of the tripod releases the legs the whole way of the tripod. Of course, on this one, you guys can already see we got rubber feet that can also be taken off and used on like some rocks or some sand. That's the lock-in mechanism. How do you let this tripod out? So that's gonna be right here, up and down, basically letting the legs out further or in further, depending on if you need a wider base or a shorter base. Other than that, that's basically it. It comes with this handle. It is a little bit heavier than my MVH 200AH. That's because we have a little bit more, I guess you could say, mechanisms going on in this tripod, but a lot more robust. You got 50 pounds per leg. So you're looking at around 200 pounds that this camera can hold. And it's, like I say, it's super easy to set this bad baby up. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it down on the ground. We're gonna go ahead and hit our latches at the top here. Lift our tripod up just like that. Hit our latches. Go ahead and throw our legs out. Make sure our tripod is nice and locked. And we are good to go. Now, in this case scenario, we can actually go higher or go shorter with just by hitting these same three latches. And this was one of the biggest reasons why I got this tripod. Now, we've all seen tripods that have done this feature before, but they haven't been this affordable. They have the Flowtech legs, which come in at, I believe, $4,000. They might have went down, might have gotten a little higher, might have gotten a little cheaper. I don't necessarily know because I'm out of the market for a quick rapid release tripod. Of course, you can, you know, buy this tripod. I will have it linked in the description below. And actually, let me show you one more thing, is that removable leg spreader. So with this allows you to basically take this camera, well, not camera, take this tripod, I believe, 8 inches off of the ground. So it gets really, 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 really low if you want it to, and that's because this mid-level spreader actually comes off of the tripod. Now, if this didn't come off, you're only, you know, of course, like the Manfrotto, you're only gonna get basically as far as it comes out. So, as you can see, there is no extra, you know, extension on this. As it comes down, that's it, it locks, and it barely, you know, it barely locks for real. Now, you can pick this up and drop it down, but with the SVT, you can actually pull it out, lock it, and when you lock it, those actually stay out, so it won't push up, won't pull up. So, you know, it's just a lot of quality of life things that I felt like I was missing and that I needed in the tripod. So I thought, hey, why not? I'm gonna be having this tripod for probably 6, 7, 8 years. So I went ahead and grabbed it, and now I think I wanna go ahead and grab that fluid head. Anyways, that's gonna be it for this video. It's been your boy Christian. This is gonna be the SVT 75 Pro. This is gonna be the rapid release system they just came out with, did the Indiegogo and everything. And you can pick this bad baby up in the description below. No need to pre-order anything. They are actually selling this bad baby right now. And yeah, make sure you guys sticking around and staying tuned for the next videos. Hope you guys did like this style of video. I kind of wanted to be a little bit, you know, I wouldn't say less professional. It still is set up pretty nice, but I didn't want to have to sit down in front of the camera and explain these things to you. I wanted to show you guys with the product in my hand. Anyways, it's been your boy Christian. Hope you guys have been enjoying the videos. If you have, make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys on the next one.